This is the new Dark Ages. And in this new Dark Ages, we are seeing a return of all manner of paganism. I could hardly believe my eyes when I saw that the Orthodox Church, which is just a split from the Catholic cult, is actually in Russia, is rejoicing that they've got some dead men's bones coming to be worshipped. Remember that actually to honour, to venerate, is to worship. The word worship in Greek comes from, as I've mentioned before in previous videos, for those of you who haven't heard it from me, to mean to actually be, to worship means to kiss towards. If you were in ancient days, you would have been on your hands and knees in front of a potentate, and you would have touched your fingers to your lips and proffered your hand. That is kiss towards. That's what it means. It looks like blowing kisses. Okay, whatever you venerate, you worship, is to you a god. And the boneheads of Russia now are so darkened, such a mess, that now they don't have any idea that this veneration of this garbage is actually wickedness and sin. Now, what does the scripture say quite plainly? You will not worship any other god but him. A god, anything you worship, hence idolatry. But here we have a gold box, an ark, I think they called it, sent by Frankie's mob in Rome to Russia, and there are queues and queues of people waiting 24 hours to go in and view the box which contains the bones of a dead man. Now, this dead man is so-called the bones, they say, and of course this is utter nonsense, the bones of Saint Nicholas or Santa Claus. Saint Nicholas, just a dead man. I can tell you that Nicholas, if he was actually soundly born of the Holy Spirit of God, would not want to be worshipped in any shape or form. In fact, he'd be terror-struck that human beings were doing anything so wicked. But here is these collective of these bejeweled, abominable befrocks with silly hats on. And if I can find a picture of it, I'll put it just here. Worshipping this box which contains the bones of a dead man. Here they are, stood around, singing hymns and worshipping. Why? Where did the Lord God ever teach that? Would you like to show me scripture for worshipping dead people? A couple of years ago, we went to visit a friend in Bulgaria, and we went to visit this Orthodox place, church place, and it had a bit of a shrine, I suppose it was. And in this particular area, they didn't have candles. There were candles, so you could put candles there, and our guide, who was Bulgarian, was lit a candle and put it in the holder, just like President Putin did, to the bones of this dead man, Nicholas. And in kind of niches in the wall behind this sort of area where there was candles burning and stuff, we saw there was bones of dead people, you know, skeletons, you know, all stacked in a heap, you know. Quite crazy stuff, crazy stuff. Please, I mean, they're dry bones of dead people, for dead for a very long time, but nevertheless. But here's these crazy church people in such darkness that they are venerating dead people. Now, let's be kind and assume that these people actually are saints. Okay. Now, a saint is sanctified one, is what it means. And it means soundly born again, child of God, who died in Christ. That's it. Sanctified one. Normal, bog-standard, entry-level, actual Christian is what it means, not church person. non-grey monster people, these are disciples. There's probably 500 of them in the UK right at the moment. Would any of those people want you worshipping them? Giving them the veneration due to him? To the Lord God of Israel? What the hell are you doing? Tell me, why do you worship those people who are saints now? You're looking at Saint Justin. Why in the blue blazes would I call myself Saint Justin? It's about as ridiculous calling myself Man Justin, isn't it? Let's not be idiotic here. But these people won't venerate modern day walking saints today, the soundly born again, they hate them. But here they are, worshipping a heap of bones of a supposed saints of the past, who probably weren't, they were just flaming church people. And yet they even make idols to these people. Utterly, totally bizarre. What does the law of God say? Idolaters, execution, no messing about. The law of God still stands. Its application's changed, okay, but the law still stands. So let's look at this thing. You have got that which is raised in the name of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, committing capital crime against the Lord Jesus Christ, against the Lord God of Israel. Okay, they did it in ignorance. They're not born again. And here they are worshipping a heap of bones. They're no better than a bunch of Hindus or Muslims or something. Are they? How are they any better? Or any other pagan savage? The unbelievable sight of these horrid creatures in gowns and ridiculous hats covered in jewels, as though they are so-called priests of God. They're a bunch of pagan savages doing things which are totally contrary to God. But the boneheads can't see, and let's be grateful we can, the boneheads just can't see anything wrong with it. They believe God instituted this, that it's in the scripture. Really? Well, my Bible says in the law of Almighty God, which still stands, applied differently today, still stands, that if those that do that will be put to death. But here we have British media carrying this story as though this was something serious. We have today, in the last day or two, Donald Trump gone to Frankie's Frog House in Rome to see Frankie in the frock. They're pagan idolaters. They carry these idols around. Look at this picture. This is a picture of so-called Saint Nicholas. This is the law of God says quite plainly, you will not make any graven image of anything on earth, in the earth, above in heaven, on earth or under the earth, neither will you bow down to it. What are these people doing? It's obscene, sickening, disgusting, repellent filth. It's Roman Catholicism, and of course the Orthodox religions just the same. The being ignorant completely of the righteousness of God in Jesus Christ, of course, is why they do it, fair enough. And they're not in our camp, they're not Christians, they're only notionals and notionals. But nevertheless, we don't take too much notice. But even so, aren't we just grateful that we don't have bone worshipping? We don't have idols. There's a great video on YouTube somewhere of the idol of the goddess Mary of the pagan Catholics being carried down the aisle of a church, and one of the bearers carrying this thing sort of mishandles it, and it drops and falls on the floor and breaks. And the Catholics nearly die on the spot because their goddess just got smashed. How hysterically funny to us. But what are you doing it for? Did he ordain that? No. Then why are you doing it? unbelievably wicked ignorance going on everywhere. You rejoice that you are free from all this. Let you and I rejoice that we don't have to do ceremonies, sermons and services. We are free. In scripture you see, beware the Judaizers. Oh, you know, unless you keep the law and you do all these ceremonies and services and all this kind of stuff, you can't be saved. Soundly rebuked in scripture. But you can't stop people being their pagan idolatry if they've never been born again. We don't have sermons, services and ceremonies and idols and pointy shed clubhouses. We're a free people. Those teachers, these creatures, the Orthodox and the Catholics and the Anglicans, who are in the new dark ages that we're in now, where the light of God's been removed from the earth. I mean, they'll live out their lives. They'll find themselves in death. From death, they wait judgment day before Christ. And from judgment day before Jesus, a thousand years or so down the tracks, they will find themselves in the lake of fire. But we've been delivered from religion. The boneheads, poor people, they just don't know. And there's no point us trying to teach them, of course. We just shake our heads, walk away, you know. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. We leave them and we walk away. We disappear. But let all of us be grateful. We have nothing to do, nothing to earn. We don't have to merit anything whatsoever. Our Lord Jesus effected it all. We just have to be found in Him. Not in church, in Him. Spiritually baptized in the Holy Spirit of God and in Him.